or life unknown.
All right, so if you've been watching our videos and finding our content helpful, please consider subscribing to our channel. Talking to you, David, Sarah, Roberto, Alan.
He's only joking, he made those names up, but you better subscribe.
Do it. Okay, so if you're thinking about visiting or traveling to Ecuador, you've probably done your fair share of research.
So in today's episode of Real Talk, we're going to be sharing with you 10 unique things that may surprise you about Ecuador.
All right, so let's get into it. Vamos! So some famous people that you might know from Ecuador, Mike Judge, who is the creator of Beavis and Butthead.
Hey, baby.
Yeah, cool. TV for my bungle. Damn it, I thought that was gonna go better. That was a bad impression. Alright, he also created King of the Hill, and he was the writer and director of the all-time classic Office Space.
What would you say you do here?
Another name you might recognize is Gerardo. Maybe more so you would know the song, Rico, Rico, Suave.
Suave. Remember those grade school dances, silk shirt, jamming out to Rico, Suave, putting the moves on the ladies.
So these are just a few famous names from Ecuador.
Yeah, definitely a lot more. So drop us a comment and let us know your favorite famous person from Ecuador.
For being such a small country, Ecuador is a leader in exporting many known goods. Bananas, shrimp, flowers, and cocoa beans. Ecuador is the number one exporter of bananas in the world.
And then shrimp, they are the number two exporter. With a lot of those going to China.
Mm-hmm. And Ecuador is the third largest exporter of flowers in the world. So with the demand for orchids and for roses.
Yeah, and then cocoa beans, right? From the cacao tree used to make chocolate. They're a big exporter of that. So Valentine's Day coming up, there's a good chance that those flowers and chocolate that you're gonna be giving to your loved ones are coming right from Ecuador.
Or receiving.
Or receiving, giving, receiving. And Ecuador's largest export is actually petroleum or oil. And they rank like 24th in the world for oil exports. Mm-hmm. So postal delivery can often be very challenging. And many times you're waiting around a long time to get a package. Mm-hmm. Hope that package comes today, huh?
Yeah,
I'm excited.
One Swedish-made penis enlarger pump.
Yes! So that package arrived, which was fortunate. But many times, packages don't arrive at all. Things are stolen, they come damaged. Or you have to pay big customs fees to get them out. In Ecuador, they do have a 4x4 rule, which is if a package is under 4 kilos and under $400, you shouldn't have to pay customs fees. But we have heard of plenty of issues even with that. So it's a challenge trying to get things shipped here or even out of here as well. Mm-hmm.
Another challenge is some towns don't even have street signs. Like here, we don't have an address, so there is no receiving any packages. So yeah. we have to go to the post office if anyone were to mail us something. Garbage pickup day is pretty interesting in our household. In the U.S., we were used to setting our garbage out on the curb, and waste management would come on a set day and pick it up.
Yes, but in many towns here in Ecuador, there is no set schedule for trash pickup, and they kind of come on random days during the week. Mm-hmm.
So instead, we listen to this song, and then run frantically. Our kids get a big kick out of it. It's like ice cream truck kind of excitement for them.
Yeah, we would just leave our trash outside of our gate or outside of our home, but the dogs get in it. There's a lot of stray dogs that get into the trash. We've had trash cans stolen, so we kind of just wait for that song. We did make a fun music video about our adventures with Trash Day, if you want to check that out at the link above.
Ecuador is considered one of the most biodiverse countries in the world. It has a varying ecosystem, so from the Andes Mountains, to the coast, the beach, to the Amazon jungle, and to the beautiful Galapagos Islands. All these regions are accessible by car or by bus, except with the exception of the Galapagos, which you have to fly to.
Yeah, one unique thing about the Galapagos Islands is that Charles Darwin's theory of evolution is largely based on his studies and discoveries that he found there. So maybe we evolved from like those blue-footed boobies or what do they have, seals
cool.
Or those crazy iguanas that are there.
If you thought the Panama hat originated in Panama, you would be mistaken.
Huh? What?
It was born here in the town of Monte Cristi, Ecuador.
Yeah, so why not the Ecuador hat? Well, it has to do with the construction of the Panama Canal in the early 1800s. So there was a big demand for these toquilla straw hats to protect the workers from the sun. And because that canal was so known internationally, people just called it the Panama hat.
So this hat is from Omidor Ortega in Cuenca. We actually visited their shop, which was lovely. And our artisan partner, Erlinda, she also makes the Panama hat.
Ecuador does have high import taxes. So things like cars, electronics, brand name items are gonna be much more expensive here. Sometimes 2 to 3 times more than what you would pay in the US. And then in terms of sales tax, they also charge 12% on pretty much anything purchased here within the country, whether that's groceries or something you're buying at the mall.
And while we have the Amazon jungle here, we do not have Amazon online shopping.
You can't be serious. You cannot be serious.
Yeah, so there isn't a real good online shopping option in terms of getting those brand name items. So we typically stock up when we go back to the U.S., fill up some suitcases, bring them here.
Yeah, or we have family or friends when they come to visit, pack some extra stuff in their suitcase for us. Move over, Mount Everest.
Dang, you moved a mountain.
Yeah, easy. Welcome, Mount Chimborazo. Actually, a volcano. It is the highest point on Earth.
Yeah, so that means it is the closest point to the sun, making Ecuador the country that's closest to the sun, which is pretty awesome. So Mount Chimborazo, in terms of height, isn't taller than Everest, but in terms of where its peak gets to, the highest point on Earth.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty cool. We gotta climb that someday, right?
Yeah.
You ready?
Oh yeah. Let's go.
Bubble.
Okay, so as expats, you might be wondering what your rights are in terms of protecting yourself abroad here in Ecuador. So as it relates to guns, Ecuador is very strict in terms of their gun laws. There is a permit that you can get to carry a gun in your home, but it is a lot more difficult to get that here. It requires justification, different background checks. And in terms of a concealed carry or carrying a gun outside of your home, there is a permit, but it's limited to ranchers, shrimpers, and entrepreneurs who can provide appropriate justification.
Mm-hmm. And you only can have a 38?
Oh, up to a 38 caliber,
yeah,
for if you have one in your home.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and it's not easy. You can't just go down to your Walmart or go online shopping for a gun here.
Yeah, I don't even know where they sell them. Like, I've never seen a gun sold anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
So much more difficult than what it is in the U.S. In 2000, Ecuador went full dollarization, so they are on the U.S. dollar. This was following an economic crisis, which basically collapsed their currency, the sucre. So that resulted in stable currency, you know, lower inflation, and more investment and trade here in Ecuador.
Mm-hmm. And cash is king. It's everything here. So small shops, taxis, they only accept cash, so it makes it a little bit more challenging.
Especially when you have those $20 bills that you want to break. They often look at you with this like...
You kidding me, sir?
Because they don't have change to break that. Even though they do have a lot of those dollar coins floating around here, it's often a mad panic trying to get change for a 20 here.
Yes. And paying bills online and payment apps aren't widely used as well.
Yeah, so like things like PayPal, Venmo, mm-hmm. the ones that we're used to using in the U.S., not used much here at all. Mm-hmm. You can do online payments for certain bills and things like that if you have an Ecuadorian bank account. We don't, mm-hmm. so like we can't use our credit cards and things like that. So we have to go directly to the bank or other payment shops to pay cash for our bills that we pay here.
Hopefully you learned some new interesting things about Ecuador. And if you found this video helpful, please give us a like.
Yeah, let's hear that Beavis and Butthead impression again. Yeah, fire. All right. Well, thanks again for joining us. Hopefully you're enjoying this content. And comment below. Let us know some interesting things that you've learned or know about Ecuador.
All right. Till next time.
Till next time. Adios.
Ciao.